The NOPD, which is the subject of several federal investigations, is also the focus of community protest. Several community organizations combined as one in a demonstration at federal court calling for a wide-ranging probe of the entire police department. WDSU anchor LaTanya Norton is on your side to explain.
At the federal courthouse today, as dozens of protesters sent a strong message to U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder.
No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
Holding t-shirts that represent empty shelves, protesters from the group Community United for Change are demanding a federal probe into alleged police murder, violence, and abuse within the New Orleans Police Department. One that dates back 30 years.
At least 30 years. Because we got some of the cops who killed people 30 years ago who are still living, and some of them are still on the police force.
Our citizens are being murdered, and no justice for them in Orleans Parish. Where is our justice?
Aiming their anger against Police Superintendent Warren Riley.
We cannot overlook his liability in this entire situation.
And every time these police kill, he comes not to the rescue of the community, but to the rescue of his police officers.
Protesters stood alongside families seeking justice in the murders of loved ones.
My son was a victim of an execution on January 1, 2009, 3 a.m.
But in 2005, he was murdered. Still no justice.
And these protesters say today is just one step in ending what they call a culture of corruption, conspiracy, and crimes against citizens. On your side, at the federal courthouse, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
The NOPD isn't responding. Meantime, the protest group will hold a public hearing Thursday at 6 p.m. at St. James AME Church, located at 219 North Durbany. Also tonight, a national article is accusing the NOPD of unfair treatment of the city's black and transgender community. An article posted on HuffingtonPost.com claims there's a systematic harassment and discrimination policy from officers, including sexual violence and improper arrests.